times of serious accidents, the first response is to rush the victim to a health facility in pursuit of emergency services offered for readily available medics. To fractured parents, careful medical assessment is a necessity to guide on treatment, plus whether one's bones can be medically fixed or removed. Ideally, one would expect medics to take all the charge at this time. However, in this report, Halton Kagure looks at how, despite all the available orthopedics, victims are smuggled into traditional bone setters clinic.
This young man survived a terrible accident along Barara Isinjiro Highway, thus becoming part of the statistics of 10,000 people who get injured every year in Uganda. This trend is manifested in country's big hospitals such as Barara Regional Referral Hospital, where accident cases account for over 80%. Saidi Wakabo, a resident of Isinjiro District, came here with broken limbs after he survived a terrible accident together with his mother, who is lined up for an operation. Like these patients in the post-surgical ward, he has been approached by traditional bone setters asking for the referral to own clinics. This is Batamaguzi Nursing Home, located in outskirts of Barara City. We find a four-year-old receiving treatment. He survived a border accident weeks ago. For almost a month here, Orishaba claims the sun is doing much better. As the morning sun sets in, most of their victims are seen emerging with their clutches to sit on the veranda together with caretakers. For Asaf, a border accident survivor, after abandoning Barara Referral Hospital, he chose to rush here. These also claim to be helped by Hope Namura, who is said to have completed her certificate in nursing to manage bones.
This nursing home, mine is to manage the wounds, to see how the cleanliness of the people, and to make sure if there is an infection like this one of corona, how people can protect themselves.
Specifically, I can say it is inherited knowledge, because it is within the family, within the Butamaguza family. Yeah, even if you ask, they will tell you when you go to the Butamaguza people, you can quickly recover. Yeah, you can easily recover, provided you go to the Butamaguza family. So it is inherited.
The bone setters don't have the science to manage this. They might have an art, because they see and tie sticks around it, perhaps that is application, that is an art. But they don't have the science to understand what is going on. For example, what is the stick doing to the bone? And what is the bone doing to the stick which they are putting? They lack the science.
Sara Kukwendakwe, a resident of Intungamo, is one of those whose leg was amputated from Mulago Hospital. 11 years since she survived an accident in Kampala, she explains to us the circumstances that prompted medics to cut off her limbs. We are now in the operating theater of Barara Referral Hospital. Here, it's equivalent to a carpentry workshop as surgeons scissor fractured bones to fix errors allegedly missed by traditional bone setters.
They end up getting a deformity. There have been instances where we've had to cause another breakage in that bone in order to put it in the right direction so that it heals properly and prevents deformity. So the traditional bone setters are creating a challenge of delays in patients getting the proper can that they would actually have.
That one is called a deadly limb, when the limb is really deadly. Okay? But also, there are circumstances when people have been mismanaged and they find their limb is really deterring them from their own doing their activities, and they think they would do better when they don't have the limb. So that is the patient now coming to us and asking for the limb to be taken off.
Having smuggled out of Barra referral for better treatment, Patrick Asimwe was rescued from a private clinic. At the hospital, he has escaped the operation after bone setter assured him of better treatment without operation. What he did, he deposited 500,000 shillings, but nothing was done apart from rotting of his foot.
All those who come from there, they will need at least blood. And blood is the most expensive thing, which you cannot get from a shop or a pharmacy, but you have to hunt for it from someone to give it to you. Definitely they will need what we call the hardware or a metal to go in there.
Our discipline of anesthesia growing has helped surgery to advance so far, because without it, like people used to do in those times where they just gave you alcohol to drink and then they come and cut you, there is no way we'll be able to do some of the things we are doing today. Okay? So when we take away that pain and make the patient comfortable, then the surgeon can actually do a very good job.
Modern medics accuse bone setters of taking advantage of patients' situations, adding that at times they are told to remain in the hospitals for virtual treatment.
That kind of management in science, it beats up my understanding. Someone is distant from you and you are handling him at a distance. That one really does not apply, and I don't understand it. That would be something like a supernatural power.
We established that it's of no doubt that traditional bone setters have won souls of many, including elites in modern hospitals.
When people are told all those issues, they want a shortcut. As you know, Ugandans, without even asking, someone is telling them the other person is going to handle you. Some of them have what we call brokers. Those bone setters are brokers in the hospital. We may not know them how they look like. They look like me and you. They come and convince these people who are in pain. They take them out. And you know, for us, if someone has decided to go, what do you do?
The rate at which people are ditching modern hospitals raises eyebrows as the ministry looks forward to streamlining.
We have village health teams. We have community engagement strategies in place. All these strategies should be used to reach the people and talk to them so that they try to understand what they should do at the right.
However, experts have partly blamed the trend on ill-equipped health systems with inadequate experts or orthopedic specialists. Uganda has 6,939 both public and private hospitals with less than 80 bone experts amidst skyrocketing accident cases per annum. According to a report by Safeway Rightway, Uganda loses $1 million, an equivalent of 380 billion shillings, to treat people who get injured on the road. Story by Halson Kagure for the news.